Hey guys, it's me again. I'm doing another how-to or how I do video. This is basically how I install cylinders on a Kawasaki triple. There's many ways of doing it, and so this isn't the only way, but the way I've been doing it since I was like 15. One thing is, you know, a lot of guys want to use hose clamps or twist ties or ring compressors. I've never found it necessary, so I'm just going to show you how I do it. First, just a few things. Just double check, make sure the bores are clean. A few things when you get your cylinders done you need to check for. They do a good chamfering job on all your ports. You should be able to rub your finger pretty hard against any of the sides of the ports, and it should feel dull. If it's sharp, that's going to basically shave the rings and wear them out. So make sure your chamfering is done well. You don't want a hot spot up here. Boring usually leaves a sharp edge, so what you want to do is chamfer this area here so it doesn't, so it's not sharp. Also, you want to chamfer the transfer cutouts inside here. Any sharp edge you want to get rid of, because that's just, flow does not like sharp edges, and in here it's just nicer for the rings when you're installing it. One thing a lot of guys don't do is, with overbores, you really need to chamfer this transition between the angle and the bore. I always chamfer this edge too to make the ring slide on easier. So basically that's all there is to that. Okay, now to the install. I already have the pistons installed. Make sure your bearings and needle bearings are good and everything's lubed up really nice. I suctioned out the crankcase last night. These check valves, the springs get old, and just the way that the oil will push through the pump and fill with the crankcase. So older motors have been sitting for a while, might have a crankcase full of oil. And so what happens when you try to start a motor that hadn't been started for like 20 years or a year or whatever, you kick it over, that oil actually gets pushed up into the top of the cylinder, or sometimes there's enough in the bottom of the cylinder to where it'll actually hydrolock the motor. And once that happens, you usually bend the rod, so you pretty much screw yourself there. So you just have to be really careful. And with a motor you don't know, one that sat for a while, go ahead, you can just pull the carbs and get the rod out of the way, and just run a long tube with a little syringe and just suck all the, make sure there's not a bunch of oil in there. So, and so now back to the install. You want to get the ring, the piston to the top dead center, and obviously on these, just have to be careful. And run the piston up. Top dead center, that just makes it a little bit easier. Okay, so top dead center. I love these pistons, they're beautiful. Next, you want to check to make sure your ring ends are over the pins. And so, got a pin there, and a pin in the back. You just kind of want to center them. They do like to move a little bit. So just be careful there. Next goes the cylinders. Again, make sure the bores, nothing's in the bore. Take some fresh two-stroke oil and I just take a finger. Actually, I got a little bit too much there, but rub some of that off. Make sure you have shop towels or paper towels handy. Make sure you get that chamfer nice. And then, oil off my finger. That's all the oil I use. A lot of guys want to put a lot of oil on or run premix or whatever. The main thing when you're breaking in a motor, these cross bores or cross hatches, they are actually not as smooth as they feel. And you actually grind in the rings. And so if you have a lot of oil in the cylinders, or you have premix, in my opinion, if you have premix or whatever, you're getting a whole bunch of oil at the time you don't want it. You want the least amount of oil, and you want the heat to burn off some of that oil, so you're actually seating the rings. So I use very little oil, just enough to do a little lubrication there. So now it's a little bit harder with the auxiliaries on, but not that big of a deal. Top dead center here. Clutch cables in the way. And just watch where your pins are. Let's get that out of the way. So let's see. Just use your transfer cutouts. Squeeze the rings. Difficult because the ring ends are on the side. Well, you can just move it back and forth.
Anything can happen right now, y'all.
Make sure it's on there. The ring end gap is on the pin here. Okay. So, put that in there. The heart is a blue. Shoes a bit. Just have to be patient. This clutch is just in the way. Strip up the cylinder. Don't get in a rush. Down there. That ring, wiggle, there she goes. Red holes. There we go. And she slides right on. One thing I didn't mention, it's kind of hard to see. On all paper gaskets on my motors, I'll get stinky and goopy, and I'll put a coating of anti-seize on both sides of any paper gaskets, especially the base gaskets. I hate scraping gaskets. This way, it actually keeps the gasket from sticking, but kind of fills in all the any irregularities. So if there aren't any big deep gouges, you'll be fine. So I do that on both sides of these, of the base gasket, so it doesn't stick. I'll also take anti-seize and just run my fingers around the bottom, not the threads, but the bottom of each of these studs, because you Kawasaki guys and Suzuki guys know that these will corrode if left on for a long time, and the cylinders are just, you'll break a cylinder just trying to get it off. So I put a little bit down there, and that just stops the corrosion on that. All right, now we're next. Right cylinder. Careful with the pistons. Slow, it's not a big deal. Okay. The right pistons. where the pins are, kind of center them. Like I said, they do move around a lot. All right, let's take our right cylinder. Again, check the bore, your gasket surfaces. Check your oil holes. Make sure they're clear. Okay, so oil holes are clear, bore's good. Okay, now back to just a light oil. Just any good two-stroke oil, or crappy two-stroke oil, it's all good these days. Okay, just a light coat there. Okay, make sure you got our stinky base gaskets. Now, take our end gaps. Pretty much center. On the back side. Just don't get in a rush and try to force things.
To lose weight? Did you follow through with it? If not, don't worry.
Good.
Your shop is here to help you lose that unwanted body fat before summer gets here. And since all staff members at NutriShop are certified sports nutritionists,
there we go. And I'll probably just stop it there because it's the same thing. Always start on the center cylinder so you can get to both sides. Do your right or left side, doesn't matter. Depends on. I'm right-handed, so it's easier from this side of the motor to left-handed. The other side of the motor. So, like I said, it's no big deal. You don't need any special tools. Just have to remember the base gaskets and don't try to force the rings. Just squeeze a little bit and wiggle and make sure it's not pushed out of the groove. And you're ready to rock pretty much. So, that's it. Hope you enjoyed it. I guess that's about it. So, guys, have a good Sunday. I am. NutriShop.